button there, and, you know, drop down. You'll see Fort Lauderdale. That'll give you our address. We're at 5600 North Federal Highway in Fort Lauderdale. We're about three-quarters mile north of Commercial Boulevard, right on Federal Highway. You can reach us by phone, 954-771-3256. And, you know, basically, you don't need to make appointments. You don't need to do anything like that. You know, if there's, you know, and I don't want to just focus on drivers. I mean, one of the things we really, really like to do with our customers is to literally go through their golf bag. You know, let's go through their golf bag. Let's find out, hey, how far do you really hit your 7-iron? You know, I mean, you might think you hit it 150 yards, but you know what? You really might only hit 130. And, you know, you might have two or three clubs in your bag that, you know, that tend to go the same distance. I know me personally, I went through it 2 years ago, and it was an eye-opener for me.
Yeah.
I was carrying two irons that went exactly the same distance.
Yeah, and so you get custom fit, but Chris, we just kind of ran out of time, but really appreciate you calling in. I know you're with your family and everything, and thank you so much. Have a wonderful weekend. Enjoy them, and we'll see you when you get back.
You got it, guys. Thanks a lot. I appreciate you letting me on.
Thank
Absolutely.
You, Chris.
Have a great night. Bye-bye.
Stay tuned. Bye. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show in just a second.
Cinderella story out of nowhere. Former Grangekeeper, now about to become the Masters Champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
I reply, call me Chocolate Thunder, and I got good two going four strokes under. Get out the way if you wanna go play, cause I give it my all every single day.
Have a lot of cash cause I sink my putts.
And we are back, and speaking of sinking putts, if you wanna sink more putts, what you gotta do is get with my buddy, from the Jess Frank Golf Academy, of course, the home of the playing lesson, and that would be none other than Jess Frank himself. He's been my co-host, and for 15 years, he's been improving golfers' ball striking consistency and distance. And he's a PGA teaching professional, owner of the Jess Frank Golf Academy, located in Boca Raton at the beautiful Boca Dunes Golf and Country Club. So if you're a seasoned golfer who's trying to break 80, or a beginner, Jess's passion is to help you play better golf and have a lot of fun when you do it. Each lesson includes on-course time with V1 video analysis, focusing on improving all facets of your game. And for a limited time, new students who mention the Golf and Travel Show will receive a $50 Edwin Watts gift card with the purchase of a series of lessons. To learn more about the services of the Jess Frank Golf Academy, call 561-213-8579. That's 561-213-8579. Visit jessfrankgolf.com or check out Jess's videos on YouTube, Facebook, and LinkedIn. Hear Elvin Bishop doing his traveling shoes. I know that's time for Jerry to kind of sneak back in here, but of course she's dealing with some issues back home, and again, we wish her the best. But she was nice enough to hook us up with somebody that she does business with and a place that I want to learn a little bit more about, and that would be our friend Kelly Fontenelle Clark, who she's a native of St. Lucia, the place that I want to learn about. Working for the St. Lucia Tourist Board since 1991 and handling responsibilities for the Southeast and the Southwest U.S., letting people like me who don't know too much about it, all about it, so that we can go visit and find out what makes this island so special. So without any further ado, I'd like to bring on board Kelly Fontenelle Clark from St. Lucia. Kelly, are you with us?
Yes, I am. Thank you for the invitation.
Oh, it's a pleasure to have you. And as I had said earlier, you know, Jerry had mentioned that she was reaching out to find out a little bit more about St. Lucia, and she had an expert who was going to tell us all about it. And I have visited many of the Caribbean islands, and it's obviously, living in Florida, it's pretty easy for us to get there, and I'm sure not too difficult from a lot of other places in the country. But what is it about St. Lucia that's different? And, you know, if you're going to pick a Caribbean island to have your vacation, why St. Lucia?
St. Lucia because, first of all, it's very easy out of South Florida. My we have American Airlines nonstop service every single day. So it's easy, very easy to get to. And St. Lucia is the most beautiful destination in the Caribbean. It's for travelers who've been everywhere, who've done everything, and they just want something unique and different, and St. Lucia is the place for them.
Now, I was taking a little bit of look at your website and trying to find out for myself a little bit. And the first thing, and I have my co-host Jess here, who's, you know, while we dabble in travel, mm-hmm. Jerry spends most of her life dealing with travel. But for us, golf is more of our life. And I didn't think that you guys had a golf course there, but boy, I was wrong, huh?
Yes, we do. We actually have two golf courses. One is at the Sandals Resort, beautiful Sandals guests. However, we have a public golf course, the St. Lucia Golf and Country Club, located in the north of the island, and it's for everyone to participate.
Well, that makes us both feel a little bit better. But obviously, golf is not what you're most famous for. So, would that be dining or diving or beaches? What is
we
the one most important thing?
Our Twin Peaks. We are a very big destination for romance, and that just kind of fall into our lap. However, we well known for diving. We have some great diving. We well known for special events. We have some great events. We have our jazz festival coming up in a couple of weeks. We also have a fantastic carnival. So we're known for events as well. And we're also well known for family reunion.
Now you mentioned romance, and we've had guests on, you know, in the past weeks talking about romance. So if you're, say, somebody who is celebrating a wedding, an anniversary, you're going to pop the question to your significant other or to be, what kind of a romantic event are you going to set up? I mean, do you have dinners on the beach? Or I mean, tell us a little bit about what is so romantic.
And that's the unique thing about St. Lucia, because we, you know, a huge romance destination. We have lots of hotels that caters only to couples or couples only. And when it comes to making it unique and different, you know, we will do something different for every single client. You know, it's not like we cutter. If you want to do a proposal, you know, we have the Peter Mountains. You can do a proposal on the Peter Mountains. If you want to do a dinner on the beach, we can do a late night dinner on the beach for you, or in a garden. And even when it comes to getting married in St. Lucia, you know, we have no residency period, so you can come visit the island on the day you want to get married, or you can get married off the cruise line. So we make it unique and special for every single client according to what they want and how they want it as well.
And, you know, for Jess and I, when we're not playing golf or when we're done playing golf, probably the cuisine would be our next choice, what we could eat and what we could drink. So I know that your history started with the French and then the British. And, I mean, did you have French food, British food, or Caribbean food, or all of the above?
And that's what makes us unique. We have the French cuisine, we have the British cuisine, and we have the Caribbean cuisine, all combined in an Afro-Caribbean, you know, cuisine. So we when it comes to culinary, St. Lucia is huge. We have some fantastic restaurants, local restaurants, and also restaurants located in different hotels, like the Dasheen restaurant at Ladera Resort. This is a very popular restaurant in St. Lucia, the Tao restaurant at Lisboa. And so there is a variety. I mean, we have an area called the Rodney Bay Village in the northern end of the island, where we have over 20 different types of restaurants. You can walk to 20 different types of restaurants. So you can have sushi one night, you can have Caribbean food, you can have French food, you can have barbecue. I mean, a variety of restaurants and food for you to choose from.
See, we should never ask questions like that on an empty stomach, because
now
you're making us hungry. But so now, some of the other things that I personally, besides the romantic part, and I know my wife isn't listening right now, so I can move aside the romantic part. But I'm really into the natural surroundings, the nature. And again, I'm not that familiar, and every Caribbean island is different. So what kind of natural things, and, you know, whether it's wildlife or flora and fauna or whatnot, are you known for?
We are known for our natural beauty and flora and fauna. When it comes to wildlife, we just have a bird and a cat, not very much of a wildlife on the island. But when it comes to flora and fauna, we have that. When it comes, you know, St. Lucia is a very dramatic island with, you know, beautiful mountains. You know, it's very mountainous. So that in itself alone gives us so much beauty. and it's a very green destination as well. You know, it's a tropical island, and, you know, we get the rain once in a while, so that keeps us very, very green.
Okay, and is there a particular time of year that's a better time of year when maybe it's not the rainy season, if folks would like to plan around that?
We are in the hurricane belt, as you know, for the rainy season from June to November. However, this is normally our driest time of year because of how, you know, where we look at it very, very far south. So any time of year is good for you to travel to St. Lucia. In the fall, we have lots of specials during the summer and the fall, so the prices are a little bit lower than during the winter time. But throughout the year is a good time to visit St. Lucia.
Now, you had mentioned cruise lines. I know some cruise lines, I mean, stop there. Is it because of the depth of your port? Do the smaller boats come or certain lines?
Oh, actually, we have all the major lines.
Major,
I mean,
okay.
One of the largest cruise lines is the Queen Mary, and she has visited St. Lucia as well.
Nice.
A lot of cruise lines visit St. Lucia because there is so much for their passengers to do. We are known for the destination of the most things to do on when it comes to shore excursions.
And you know, you mentioned things to do, so another thing that I would be interested in, especially for an island that I've never been to before, would be, you know, the history. I mean, do you have, like, museums or ways to find out a little bit about the history of the island?
Yeah, we have a lot of, our national park, Pigeon Island National Park, has a lot of history. Actually, it's located where it was one of the battlegrounds for the French and the British. St. Lucia is about 15 minutes away from Martinique, so when you're at Pigeon Island, you can actually see Martinique. And Martinique was where the French, you know, the French were looking, and the British were able to see when the French army was coming. So a lot of history right there at Pigeon Island National Park, and we do have a museum there who will tell you all about the history. And the entire island itself, I mean, we have petroglyphs in certain areas where, because, you know, we had the Caribs and the Arawaks before, you know, the French came in. And we have petroglyphs all around the island in certain areas, especially on the west coast of the island where the Caribs were first inhabited. We still have some old huts of, you know, how they lived in those times.
Wow, that must be very interesting.
Yeah, a lot of history on the island. And you know, it's said that Napoleon's wife was born in St. Lucia. Josephine Bonaparte was born in St. Lucia. So there's a lot of history on the island.
I wonder how that worked for her. But now, while I'm not a big fan of it, a lot of people who are golfers like Jess and myself are also fishermen, so I would have to believe that there's some sort of good fishing down there?
There's some fantastic fishing. We have a billfish tournament, actually. It's in always in end of September, October, when the water is a little bit warmer. And the fishing, we have fishermen come from all over the Caribbean, a few from the U.S. and Europe, who come to be part of our fishing tournament. I think a couple of years ago, the biggest fish that was caught was an 1,100-pound blue marlin.
Oof.
I don't think anybody has broken that record yet for that fish, but fishing is a big thing on the island as well.
Wow. That's a lot of fish and chips you can make right there, I think. But So it seems to me that one of the biggest things, though, again, that we briefly touched on is the diving. So is there like coral reefs or just lots of very colorful fish? Or what do people dive? What do they find when they go diving?
A little bit of everything. There's a coral reef. There's lots of beautiful fish. There's we have a wreck as well that was done, I think, many years ago. We had a wreck, for more reasons to dive in St. Lucia. And because of we have an area in Soufre called where Superman the movie was filmed, the original one was filmed, and then he did, I don't know if you remember when he dove to get a flower for Lewis. This was filmed in St. Lucia. They actually named that dive the Superman's Flight.
Very nice.
Quite nice, yeah. And there's supposed to be this thing in St. Lucia called a sting that, you know, only comes out at night, and only a few people have seen it. So divers come down to St. Lucia to see if they'll see this thing that's supposed to be some underwater creature that could be found only in St. Lucia. And divers come out to look for it once in a while. So there's a lot of diving, beautiful diving down there.
Well, I got to tell you, I now know a lot more about St. Lucia than I knew before. Yeah. We're just about out of time, so I wanted to thank you for joining us. Now, I got a couple of websites here for information. It looks like StLuciaNow.com or...
StLuciaNow.com, yes. You can get them. You know, we just... have the Bachelor on islands. We have the Red Rose packages, so the clients can do exactly what the Bachelor, you know, the Bachelor did.
And who doesn't want to do that?
I know.
And also StLuciaJazz.org if you want to find out about the jazz show that you got coming up. And, of course, if anybody wants to book a trip, they can go to our travel expert, Jerry Augustine, of Sea Dreams Travel at 561-310-9337 or SeaDreamsTravel.com, and they can arrange for you to go visit St. Lucia. So, like I say, this was great, and I really appreciate you spending some time with us. And all of our audience, I'm sure, knows a heck of a lot more now than they knew before about St. Lucia as well. So thank you so much, Kelly.
Thank you so much for inviting me. Have a good weekend.
Oh, thank you. Same to you. All right. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to just take another quick break, and then we're going to be back with a little bit more. We've got one more guest coming up, and it's going to be more interesting stuff, so you won't want to miss it. So stay tuned. And we're back, and I'm going to go marching right down to St. Lucia, I think,
like
is what
it.
I'm going to do. But
if
you want to go marching down to St. Lucia, what you need to do is give a call to Sea Dreams Travel, which is, of course, the home of our own Jerry Augustine. And if you've been looking for that perfect vacation and you want the best value, but you're tired of searching on the Internet or holding on some toll-free number with an automated booking agent, well, that's just crazy, because at Sea Dreams, you can benefit from Jerry and her team's vast knowledge, buying power, protection, and added values that you won't find on your own, all at no extra cost to you. A perfectly planned vacation, hassle-free, and filled with unforgettable moments. And you can join the Sea Dreams team on a 7-day Caribbean cruise aboard the beautiful new MSC Divina, departing on January 24th. Prices start at only $379, with special amenities designed just for you, and kids sail-free. So for all the details on this special cruise, as well as to find out about other specials, you can give Jerry a call at 561-310-9337. That's 561-310-9337, or visit SeaDreamsTravel.com. Sea Dreams Travel, your world, your way. And we are back for our final segment, and as I had mentioned before, we never eat dinner before the show, and we end up talking about all this great cuisine, and a bottle of red, a bottle of white, and I don't know, I think this next guest is really going to put us over the edge when we start talking about the cuisine of Italy, and what we're going to do is we're going to bring on in just a second Guido De Ugo, and he's the managing director of North America for Ciao Italy, as well as Cariani Tours, and he's been specializing in a travel to Italy for the longest time. That's really his passion, and basically since 2006 he's been working with Ciao Italy Travel, and they're suppliers for travel agents and for folks like anybody who's listening who would like to go see Italy. And Italy is a big place and it's complex. There's lots of different regions, lots of different things to see, and if you do it on your own, you're probably not going to do it right, so you need to have an expert hooking you up. So to find out all the places that you need to go to in Italy, we're going to have our own resident expert for the evening, Guido De Ugo of Ciao Italy. Guido, are you with us?
Yes, buonasera, good evening, this is Guido.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you, and I'm here with Jess. Of course, Jerry couldn't make it this evening, and I know that she had reached out to you because she knows that you're an expert and you know a lot more than we do about Italy. Italy is a place that I have visited once, but just to one region, the northern area, and I loved it. I just can't wait to go back. So, and I can't wait to hear a little bit from you about some of the places that you think are really special that, you know, so somebody like myself, perhaps, who hasn't really seen much of Italy, where do you start?
Oh, well, You can't go wrong. Any place you start in Italy, you are going to travel in a beautiful, unique place. I would say if it is the first time or the second time that you are going, you definitely want to see Rome, Florence, and Venice. These are the must-see, of course.
Of course.
But if you've been there a couple of times, then I definitely would suggest Tuscany, the Lakes region, and the beautiful Amalfi Coast, Sicily. So there is really, really a lot to do. And, you know, we deal with travelers that go there the first time. They come back, and they are ready to plan their next trip. They just keep on asking for new destinations to see in Italy.
Well, am I not surprised to hear that? Now, obviously, when we speak to different guests who are experts on travel, whether it be, you know, here in North America, South America, or Europe, there's different methods of transportation. You know, we've spoken to folks who have different kinds of boats and cruise lines, big ones, little ones, train trips, car trips. What do you recommend? How's the best way to get around in Italy?
Depends on what your expectations are then. There are a couple of ways. One is just to book a tour. You would go on a motor coach with a nice group of people. You can relax, sit back, and just let us take care of you. Another way is traveling a little bit more independently by train. Okay? So the train system in Italy is very well organized, and all the main cities and sites are very well connected, and you can comfortably travel in first class. And we have also English-speaking drivers that would pick you up at each train station, take you to the hotel, thank you for touring. So ideally, certainly, to do an independent travel arrangement with the private drivers and private tours is the most enjoyable way to see Italy. But, you know, it also depends on the budget.
When I go traveling, at least here in the States, I'm not afraid to rent a car and take off by myself. But for some reason, when I go to a foreign country, especially if I don't speak the language, I just get a little bit nervous. I can only guess that, especially in a place like Rome, that the driving may be a little bit kooky, huh? A little nutty.
Yes, you are right. There are some areas where you are okay. You can be safe driving, like, for example, in Tuscany. You can rent a car and just drive yourself through the countryside. The small towns is pretty quiet. But now when you go to big cities like Rome or Milan, you certainly want to stay away from that driver's seat.
Yeah, no, I want to be able to relax on my vacation
I've
and not chew my fingers to the bone, you know, being nervous. But so we were talking earlier, and we were listening to our music about the wine. Why don't you touch a little bit about some of the wine and some of the food? Because obviously that would be one of the most important reasons that I could possibly think of to visit Italy.
Oh, absolutely. And actually, it is one of the most requested activities, food tasting, wine tasting, and the food is spectacular. Each region has its own specialties, and you can travel from north to south and just taste the different flavors, different specialties. And each meal, of course, has to be paired with the proper wine. So wine also is present throughout Italy. The most famous region for wine is probably Tuscany. Every region in Italy has its own wine, and it's very popular, very common to do wine tasting. You go to wineries and you visit the estate, and you do some wine tasting. You really learn a lot about wines, how to pair wine with food, and you come back to the U.S., you're almost an expert.
Either that or you're addicted to drinking or something, to Italian wine. You can't stop, probably. But now, another thing that I find fascinating, of course, is the history. And, you know, there's so many places to see in Italy. Why don't you touch on a couple of the high points, whether it's the Vatican or the Leaning Tower of Pisa or the canals in Venice? What maybe the top three or four places that are just must-see in Italy?
Well, the Vatican is the most visited site in Europe. It's actually always competing with the Louvre Museum in France. But you cannot miss the Vatican Museums, the Sistine Chapel, and St. Peter's Basilica. That is the number one site in Italy. Obviously, since you're Rome, you're going to see the Colosseum, the Roman Forum, and all the ancient part of Rome. In Florence, you have the two museums, the Accademia, the Uffizi Gallery, and of course, going to Venice, you have to go into the San Marco Basilica, the Doge Palace, and take a nice ride on the gondola. So these are basically the most common sites. But you see, every corner in Italy, no matter where you go, where you turn, there is something interesting, something historical or artistic to see. You're basically immersed in art and history 24/7.
And of course, how about a little bit about the people? I would guess that the people are welcoming and friendly and have some nice stories to tell to the visitors.
Yes, absolutely. People love tourists. Italians especially love Americans. There is this great relationship, and they are extremely friendly. When you just walk around, you ask for information, you get lost. They are always willing to help you. They are very friendly, and from asking or where is a certain site, you can easily wind up having a drink with some Italian family and starting a long-term relationship with some Italians. So people are very warm, welcoming, and that also makes this destination unique.
I tell you, I have a vision of meeting some stranger and having a meatball and a glass of Chianti. I don't know, but it sounds right. Another thing that's really cool, when I went to Italy, I flew in and out of Milan, and there are a lot of people that are really into the fashion industry, and obviously that's like a mecca for, you know, the cutting edge fashion. Right? I mean, that's a great place to do a little bit of shopping, huh?
Yes, definitely. Milan is, of course, the capital of fashion, and shopping is very big in Milan. In fact, we organize shopping tours. You can have a personal shopper, and all the major designers have a location in Milan. However, throughout Italy as well, you know, you can do some, you can find designers everywhere in Italy, and Florence also is very big for shopping. You can find a really nice leather in Florence, and, you know, just to mention, speaking about Florence and leather, there is this market, the Mercato di San Lorenzo is called, where you can still find the artisans that work the leather, that produce bags and belts with the same system that I've been using over 100 years, and these products are really unique, and they are the authentic made in Italy.
Hey, I only brought that up because I know my wife isn't listening. So if she was listening, I don't want her to know about this. But we're just about out of time. And what I want to do is first of all, thank you, Guido, for telling us a little bit more about Italy and Ciao Italy Tours. And what I'd like to do, if it's okay with you, is suggest that people give Jerry Augustine of Sea Dreams Travel, our resident travel agent, a call if they would like to book a trip through Ciao Italy. And you can reach her at 561-310-9337 or seadreamstravel.com. And thank you so much, Guido. It was really interesting to learn a little bit more about Italy from your perspective, from an expert's perspective. So thank you so much.
It is my pleasure. My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
All righty. So there you have it. What a well-rounded show tonight.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
So I'd like to thank all of my guests, Chris Hamler of Edwin Watson Fort Lauderdale, Kelly Fontanelle Clark of the St. Lucia Tourist Board, and, of course, Guido D'Ugo of Ciao Italy. And, of course, thanks to my co-hosts, Jerry Augustine of Sea Dreams Travel, 561-310-9337 or seadreamstravel.com, and Jess Frank of the Jess Frank Golf Academy, 561-213-8579 or jessfrankgolf.com. And, of course, you could like us on Facebook at facebook.com, The Golf and Travel Show. And we'll have another great show for you next week at the same time, so make sure you tune in.
You have been listening to The Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu, heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 a.m. WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit them straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsor program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors.